Well, Thomas, we understand that you're the coach and it's not necessarily your job, but we do understand within the last half an hour or so, that Chelsea are preparing to withdraw from the idea of a European Super League. What can you tell us now?
About that?
Yes.
Nothing. I spent the last 45 minutes in the bus waiting to be allowed to come to the stadium. No, I don't know nothing about that. What I know and what I'm aware of, and this is now my personal opinion, that I'm in a super competitive club. And that's why I'm here, and that's why I was so excited to join this club. And I trust the club too, that it's all about competition. And this is what I feel in the dressing room, and this is what I feel in Cobham. And this is what everybody feels when they watch our team play in the last weeks. We were fighting so hard to go to Champions League semi-final. We were giving everything in FA Cup, in the oldest, most traditional cup. We were giving everything. We left our heart and soul on the pitch to make it to the final. So we are competitive, and I can repeat. I'm not aware of any of the politics. I was not aware. I'm still not aware. I don't know enough. And I trust the club that they take decisions in the consideration that we embrace competitive sport.
What's it been like trying to prepare a team against this backdrop? Even now, you talked about being delayed, traveling it through your own fans.
Yeah, honestly, it's a bit annoying and a bit frustrating because from Monday on, we wanted to build the momentum and the atmosphere. Of focus, of concentration, and of being ready after, like I said, after a tough week in Champions League and FA Cup. We wanted to create full focus on this game here against Brighton and West Ham in Premier League, because it's a crucial week for us. We're in the race for top four. It's in our hands. There was no way of doing it, because it was too much and it was out of our hands. It was not our fault. And so maybe, okay, it was a distraction, but it's no excuse. But at some point today, we had to understand, in my opinion, and to accept that we are a bit distracted. That's a different kind of a preparation. And now we will see. Hopefully we can enjoy the time out there on the pitch, and the guys can enjoy their team together out there on the pitch and perform nevertheless.
So what do you say to your players then to get them right with all this going on?
No, I just think not very much. We talked about the game, of course, but we allowed them also to be a bit distracted, and we allowed them to talk about it. I did not have the feeling then talking today and yesterday all the time, no, don't focus only on the focus only on the game would help them. It's too many things going on. The captains talk to each other, I think, and the captains of the league. So players are involved in this, and you have to accept it. So we accepted it until now. The bus had a delay, so it is not normal. So we cannot. I did not feel that I should pretend that everything is normal. So we accepted it and still want to have a good performance and the top result.
And lastly, if the club have then stepped in and drawn a line under all this, is that welcome for you? It means more sport and politics questions?
If
this is dead and you don't have to answer any more questions about it, is that welcome for you?
But we can do this straight away. It's on you. You just don't need to ask me, because, like you said in the beginning, I'm the coach. I mean, if we change the tactics today and it does not work out, you will clearly ask me, because it's my job to do. But I fulfill a part in a club, in a successful club, in a big club, and in a very competitive club. And I think you have to also to respect it, that I play my part and play my role. And everything else, if we have opinions to share, we do this behind closed doors.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.